This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part two of the unit circle definition for trig functions. And here's the definition that we discussed in part one. The point is that if you have an angle in standard position and you choose a point that intersects the unit circle, in other words, a circle with radius 1, then that ordered pair, the cosine will be the x coordinate and the sine will simply be the y coordinate. So here's a unit circle where all of these ordered pairs are shown for the special angles between 0 and 360 degrees, or 0 and 2 pi. And if we did have this, then you could simply look at the x-coordinate or the y-coordinate to figure out the cosine or sine of any of these. So for instance, if I said, whoops, I wonder why that moved a little. Here we go. So let's say we wanted to find out what the cosine of 2 pi over 3 was. So we locate 2 pi over 3, which is right here, right? And if you want the cosine, you want the y value for the cosine. That is simply the cosine of 2 pi over 3. So the cosine of 2 pi over 3 is negative 1/2. Now, if you were finding the tangent, you would divide the y-coordinate divided by the x-coordinate. But if you just wanted to find the cosine, it's simply the x-coordinate. If you wanted to find the sine, it's the y-coordinate. So let's just do one more. What if we wanted to find the sine of 240 degrees? So I locate 240 degrees over here is the point that would intersect it. Now, I'm not drawing the whole angle because it gets messy drawing all these angles, but I'm looking at a point on the terminal side. And the sine means you're going to just take the y-coordinate. So that'll be negative square root of 3 over 2. So if you did have this circle with all these ordered pairs on it, it would be easy to read the cosine or sine for any of those special angles. Let's do a tangent. So let's say I wanted to do the tangent of 11 pi over 6. So what would that be? I locate 11 pi over 6. The tangent is y over x, so it would be negative 1/2. Whoops. It would be, for the numerator, negative 1/2. And in the denominator, square root of 3 over 2. Okay, so you could write that as negative 1/2 times the reciprocal, which is 2 over square roots of 3. The 2's cancel, so you get negative 1 over square roots of 3. And if you rationalize the denominator by multiplying the numerator and denominator by square root of 3, you would have negative square roots of 3 over 3 for the tangent. So as you can see, the tangent, you have a little bit more arithmetic to work through. The sine and cosine are easy. You just read the x-coordinate or the y-coordinate. So if you want to know how to get those ordered pairs on the circle without figuring them all out on your own, there is a little trick you could use. All right, so first of all, notice I have a unit circle. So I have the ordered pair 1, 0, 0, 1, negative 1, 0, and this one at the bottom, that will be, let's see, I'll make it black, 0, negative 1. Okay, now what I have is I've kind of drawn in where the special angles are, but I'm not labeling them because it gets kind of crowded on here. But for instance, this first blue line would be 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees. Okay, then over on this side, that would be 90 plus 30, so it would be 120, 150, 120, 135, and 150, right? And so on. So you can see the special angles. In other words, the ones in red really are at the 45 degree angles. So how would I figure these out? So I'm going to try to figure out these ordered pairs. And it's really the ones here in the first quadrant that I'm going to do first, because this is a little trick. And I did a chart like this in a previous video that showed you a pattern going on. All right, let's look at the x-coordinate of this order pair at the top, 0, 1. So remember, that's the cosine? So that's the cosine of 90 degrees, right? And notice if you go down to the right, you end up with a 1 for the cosine of 0 degrees. Well, there's a little trick. It's the square root of 0 over 2 is how you can get this first coordinate. The second one going down is square root of 1 over 2. The next one is square root of 2 over 2. The next one is square root of 3 over 2. And the last one, 1, is the same thing as the square root of 4 over 2. Now, for square root of 1 over 2, you could probably do that in your head. Square root of 1 is just going to be 1, but that's where it comes from. So that's how to get the x coordinates. It kind of goes down from 0 for the numerators. Square root of 0, square root of 1, square root of 2, square root of 3, square root of 4. And the denominators are all 2. Now, right at the 45 degree angle, the x and y coordinates are the same. So this is the same. You might recall that the cosine of 45 degrees and the sine of 45 degrees are the same because the x and y coordinates happen to be the same. And we just switch the x and y values here for the 30 and the 60 degrees. So this is 1 half, and this is square root of 3 over 2. So that's a little trick for getting those ordered pairs there. Now, once you have those ordered pairs, you could figure out all the rest of these, because the only thing that might change for the ones that are sort of like a mirror image through here is you might have a negative sign for the x or y coordinate, depending on over to the left of the y-axis, all the x-coordinates will be negative, and below the x-axis, all the y-coordinates will be negative. So for instance, let's look over here in quadrant 2, up here at 120 degrees. That's really the same level, right, as this one right here, okay, sort of the same level. So if I went over 1 half and up square roots of 3 over 2, here I'm going to the left 1 half. So the difference is that the x coordinate will be negative 1 half, but the y coordinate is still up square root of 3 over 2. What about the 45 degree angle right here? So this is at 135 degrees. Okay, so instead of being square root of 2 over 2, square root of 2 over 2, the x-coordinate is negative. So it's negative square root of 2 over 2. But y-coordinate is still positive. I'm not going to fill all these in, but you could go in and fill the rest of them. But let's just do like another one down here in quadrant 3. Let's say I wanted to figure out what this coordinate right here is. That's the 180 plus 30 degrees, so 210 degrees. It would look like whatever this blue one was, which I didn't write, so let's write that one. The x coordinate is negative, so negative square root of 3 over 2, but it's positive. If I go down here, it just means both of them are going to be negative. So I have negative square root of 3 over 2, negative 1 half. And then you could go ahead and fill out the rest of this on your own. Personally, I never, you know, make up a circle like this with all the order pairs. It just seems like a lot of work. It's easier for me to just simply draw a triangle and figure out the sine, cosine, and tangent of special angles differently. But some students like to do this. They like to just go ahead and fill this out, and then it's sort of like their little cheat sheet. And so that's up to you if you want to do that. And this is just a way of doing it. All right, on the next video, we're going to show like the usefulness of this unit circle definition and how it relates to what we call the circular functions. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.